Hello and welcome to another week of The Kickoff. I'm Tim Morgan. Plenty of football to get through both internationally and domestically. To help me do it, Naum Sekulovski joins me almost 200 odd games across the NSL and Perth Glory. Thanks for joining us here.
Thanks for having me, Tim. Nice to get involved and what a week of football we've got coming up.
I've done you our Macedonian marvel and I've left off almost your greatest accolade. You're the great grandson of a man who wrestled a bear. Please, tell me that story.
Jeepers, the Macedonian marvel might be a little bit too much, but I'll take it. So thanks for that. The bear hunter, or the ranger, just doing what he had to do back in the day, keeping his villagers safe, pops the bear in the right shoulder, and then gets into some sort of UFC Volkanovski-style fight, rolls down the mountain and has to put the bear into captivity just to keep the villagers safe, just to make sure.
This isn't some family wife's tale, is it? It's in the paper, it is printed.
True story, we've got the black and white to prove it. And it was just run-of-the-mill stuff that happened back in the village. So true story. I do have a big nose, but I can assure you it's got nothing to do with Pinocchio's tail. So he is the real deal.
Now, you're still running around trying to get a kick down at Preston. Have you ever thought maybe to get some fans in? You go Jackie Moon style, semi-pro, get the bear in one night only and try and wrestle one, or you leave that to the relatives?
Never say never. Never say never.
We'll buy tickets to that. That might get us another week on the kickoff if they let us back. But let's get into tackling the big issues in football. And there's plenty of them this week. We're going to start with the Socceroos. 2-2 draw with Oman. Suddenly the road to Qatar looks like we're taking a detour. We're going to go the long way. What did you make of the performance and are we going to be there at this year's World Cup?
Look, it's always tough away from home. We know the lads have had, we've all had an interesting couple of years. Ideally, you know, the 3 points would have been great. I think we look at the games ahead now and, there's an opportunity there where we can drive what we can control with the game versus Japan and obviously Saudi Arabia. And then the rest of it's up to, you know, what lands in terms of other results. So I think just focus on them two games. They'll come out of it. They'll reassess. Arnie and the lads will reassess. And they'll get ready for really the games where, you know, it's slightly uncomfortable. But as Australians and as footballers in Australia, we've known and we've grown up in operating in that uncomfortable space because, you know, that's where we're at as a footballing nation.
Do you reckon that's a bit Arnie drummers down? Destiny's in your hands? And as bad as all the talk is around it, just remember that the destiny is in your hands.
Look, absolutely. We're in the driver's seat for them two games. That's what we focus on. So we get the 6 points there. Whatever happens after that, we tackle it. You know, we always have, you know, as a nation, whether it be in football or in other sporting fraternities, that's just the way we are as a culture, as a people.
Nowhere left to go for the Matildas, sadly. Out of the Asian Cup. Plenty of pressure on Tony Gustafsson. Has it been fair? And obviously the big goal being the World Cup next year.
Again, we, as Australians, we always want the result. I think we just have to balance it out, reflect, and probably a good opportunity to reset. It's one of them ones where we're lucky we've got the default qualification in terms of the World Cup. So we're blessed. Now use the time that we've got leading in, potentially even tap into the local resource of the A-League with the women and see how we might be able to reshuffle that squad and gear up for, you know, for what's going to be an exciting World Cup.
Should they back the coach in?
Look, you know, I don't know if you want to go making drastic changes, you know, leading into the World Cup that's not too far, you know, around the corner. So I think just, again, it's an opportunity as a collective to reset and really tap into that local A-League women's competition and just see where we might be able to refine.
So the centrepiece of this weekend's action is Saturday night, FFA Cup final between Melbourne Victory and the Central Coast Mariners. Now, the Mariners, big blow for them. Jason Cumming's out. It'd be a fairy tale, really, I think, if the Mariners were to get up. But on the Victory side of it, Tony Popovic can really stamp that his era is here, can't he?
Well, Pop has come in, wholesale changes, and he might have his first piece of silverware within, you know, the first 3-4 months of his tenure. And you know, then you've got Central Coast, great club. You know, I can always remember the big sauce bottle, the big Master Foods. Where else would you rather be playing in front of a massive sauce bottle over there at Central Coast? But Monty's a great lad. He'll have him fired up. And again, what's at stake? An opportunity or a place there in the Asian Cup, is that right?
Yeah, in the Asian Champions League.
Yeah, so, there you go, in the Asian Champions League.
Yeah, it's really added something to this competition and obviously, Tony Popovic, a man who's had plenty to do with that tournament, I'm sure he's using that as motivation this week.
Yeah, absolutely, they would be. You can tell how much I've been following local football. I said Asian Cup instead of Asian Champions League. But we play on. We push on, Timmy.
Still, mate. Matildas. You were thinking about the Matildas.
Yeah,
absolutely.
Correct,
do you have a tip for that game?
I'm going to go with victory. Being a local lad, Pop is a champion bloke and he's got a really good squad there.
That's really going to be victory is back. So on to the A-League action. It does start Friday night. Adelaide United up against Sydney FC. Stephen Mork, Craig Goodwin are going to be back. So what do Adelaide do now? They've got the 15-year-old wonder kid, Nestori Iragunda. Does he still play or does he have to now bide his time after that ripper free kick?
15-year-old taking free kicks, you've got to play him. You've got to just back the lad in. Yeah, but again, that's going to be up to Carly and how he wants to set up. It's probably a good problem to have for most coaches in having or being spoiled for choice in that situation.
Who's your tip?
I'm going to go Adelaide.
They're starting to build a bit of momentum, aren't they? Sydney FC been struggling. Joel King going away. Going to be tough for them to rebuild, I reckon. So Saturday afternoon, West United, Western Sydney Wanderers, and this is really all about one thing. Mark Rudan, he's got the first win on the board. Now he takes on the old side.
Yeah, he's back. He was actually my neighbour there for a while, there in the northwest of Melbourne. But yeah, good to see him get his first win. Got a really good opportunity versus Western United. They've obviously started quite well and sitting on top of the table. Yep, I know there's teams that have played a few more games than others. But again, going to be a really good tussle between these two clubs.
Do you think the Wanderers get that bounce to continue? Or will Western be more fired up taking on the old man in charge?
I'll back in Western. Again, just going with the locals.
Lovely. On to Sunday's action. And we've got the Wellington Phoenix up against MacArthur. I was keen to drum down onto MacArthur here and a man who's played plenty of football. We didn't see them, essentially, after Boxing Day. They've now got two matches in 6 days. Just how hard physically is it to go from one extreme to the other?
It's always hard, Yakka, but, I mean, as elite athletes, these guys would be managed to the millimetre. So they're going to be ready. They're going to be prepared and they're going to understand what's at stake. So I think although circumstances are difficult, they'll be there and ready to take the 3 points. And you've got two great coaches that have had long history in playing together with Tezza and Uffi. So again, a really good battle of the coaches here and the tactical side of the game.
The table would suggest it's MacArthur. Is that the way you're going?
I am
going
to go with Tezza, another old teammate. So I'm going the easy line here, Timmy, honestly.
Oh, you're just backing in your mates, which is a good thing to do. It's a very good quality to have, that's for sure.
It's not a bad thing.
So Sunday night, City, Perth Glory. Perth obviously went down in that match against the Wanderers. City, the inclusion list could be Naboot, McLaren, Leckie, Tilio and Metcalf. Too strong?
Brilliant. I mean, you get all these guys back from the Socceroos. It's really bolstered their chances in this game. They are probably going in as favourites anyway. Just a quick shout out from a Perth Glory perspective. It is my old club, so I still do have that soft spot there for Perth. And also another plug for young Jacob Young, an old teammate of mine, Stewie, who looked after me like a cup favourite when I initially went to Wollongong. So it's great to see, and I think across the A-League as a whole, you know, young talent finally coming through and really getting an opportunity at the top level.
Do you think Perth are starting to go, why do we spend so much on Daniel Sturridge? We can't sell any tickets because they're not playing at home.
Yeah, it will probably take and make sure we don't mention Mark McGowan too much within this conversation. But it's going to be difficult because they've got a boutique stadium. You make a big, a massive signing and, you know, to not be able to showcase that, it is a little bit unfortunate. But we move on. We push on.
Norm, thank you so much for your time. I think you've been very good on debut. Archie Thompson might need to watch out. A man's coming for his job, though. Did you play with him? No, you didn't play.
I played against Archie, another great lad. I'm happy to wait on the bench, Timmy. All good.
Norm, thank you so much. Going to be a really big weekend in Australian football. Of course, you can catch all of it on Paramount Plus and Channel 10.